So we'll go ahead and call the meeting to order. We do have a quorum present. Did everybody have an opportunity to look over the minutes from July 13th?
Yes.
Yes.
Any questions, comments, concerns?
Move to approve.
Second.
Okay, so we had Jack make a motion, and was that Randy that approved?
Yes. Yes, it was.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries, or opposed? Sorry. Attempt again to go all here. It's a small group today. Any opposition? Okay, so motion carries. We have agenda item number 3, consideration of a letter of design approval for the exterior building modifications located at 224 South Charge Street.
Yes, so this is our only item on the call today. So this is for exterior building modifications at 224 South Charles Street. There is 4 structures on the site. The first is an office building, which faces Charles Street. And it's currently a metal building with siding on the front facade. So they're proposing some changes to this building, a new parapet wall with signage and gooseneck lights, an extended porch, 2 windows on the front facade, 2 windows on the north facade. The other buildings are currently really sort of sheds. Building 2 is kind of the least visible of the buildings, and it's really just kind of a shade structure. It's proposed to be enclosed with the same corrugated metal that it's constructed out of, and it would have a sliding barn door and 2 gooseneck lights. Building 3 is also a storage structure right now, and it would be expanded with a large awning and then enclosed with fiber cement siding that would be painted an alabaster color. And then the 4th building is adjacent to Elm Street, and it's really open-sided right now, so it would also be enclosed with corrugated metal. And then there would also be 2 entryway features added to the site with a timber wood gate, and they'd allow for a hanging sign. And so the sign would actually be brought forward at a later date, but I want to just kind of go through and show the pictures of what's being proposed, and then I'll go and show you some photos that staff took of the site as it is today, and we can kind of look at the proposed improvements. So see some of the light fixtures. I want to get down to the renderings and the color selections, and then the materials. Oh, let's see. Let's go to view. Sorry about this. So this is the site layout. And you can see these are the buildings that would be enclosed, 2, 3, and 4. This is kind of the elevations of what the structure would look like. And here you can see they're proposing to take down a large portion of the wooden fence that right now kind of walls in the site. But for security purposes, they would do an ornamental metal fence. Now, that's not something that the OTDRC gives approval of in terms of fencing, but I think it makes a really huge difference in the way that this site will look from the street. And so it's definitely worth mentioning because you will see those structures.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. So here's the rendering. As a note, the rendering doesn't include that raw or tubular steel type fence that would go around the property line. But here you can see the site from the north. And here it is from Charles Street. And here's kind of that 4th building that would be enclosed. Here's that 3rd building. The 2nd building that you don't really see a whole lot of. And then the office building that's going to kind of get this false front parapet on the front of it. So let me go now to show you some images. Of the current site. Let me just get these. So here's a photo of the current site. You can see the fence, the wooden solid fence that goes around the property. And you can see some of the existing trees, most of which would remain. The palm trees in particular, very lovely trees on the site. Trying to figure out what the most effective way to show you all of these pictures is. Here's another photo. This is looking along Elm Street, and you can see that's the roof of what would be building number 4 that would be enclosed with metal. By that power pole is about where that northern driveway would come out, just in front of that. And then again, open style fencing, so you can actually see into the site, see that there's an operating business there that has items for sale. So I think that sort of concludes my presentation, but I'm happy to answer any questions, and we also have the applicant here with us today as well.
The only question I had looking through it was I saw there was a number of gooseneck lights on there proposed. What's the thinking behind having the variation in them, or were those just multiple options and then they're all going to be the same?
You've got some of them are for the signage and some are for the building. The ones going around the buildings themselves at more of the human scale are going to be one style, and then the one so you get the one up over the sign, which is a double. And then I think everything except the sign and then the front door ones right there are pretty much the same.
Okay. So there's some consistency on that internal courtyard kind of looking area.
Exactly.
With the lighting. Okay. That was my only question. Just clarification, really.
Jack or Randy, did y'all have any comments or questions?
Looks good.
Well, it looks good. One of the images had, I believe it was just a rendering issue, had striping right up in front of the garage door. Is that parking, or is that going to be a front door?
So let me pull that site plan up.
This one here. You trying to get those, Jack?
So those will be parking spaces, but they're kind of intended for folks to back into with their pickup trucks to pick up their feed.
Okay.
Kind of a loading, unloading kind of zone.
Yeah. And that's going to be reviewed by engineering, correct? I imagine all the site stuff is going to be reviewed by engineering. Okay.
I'd like to congratulate all those involved. I think this does a great job of kind of a manifesting what Old Town is all about, and so thank you.
Yeah, I think it looks great too.
I think it's very complimentary, and I like the mixed use of materials. It's very fitting for what's coming, and I think it definitely is an asset to the area. Being directly across from the distillery, and then we have, you know, all the residential different kind of styles that have come in. I think it, you know, was really suited for what it is and its purpose of restoration.
Yeah, and all these barn doors are going to be operational here.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Well, it's even cooler.
I move to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you all very much.
All right. The motion carries. And we had Jack. I can't remember, Michelle. I feel like you asked me to make sure that we knew who did what, if I remember correctly, in the last meeting. So that was Jack that made the motion. And
I second.
Okay, there you go. Justin seconded. And then we were all in favor.
Thank you for that. Appreciate it.
All right, do we have a motion to adjourn?
Move to adjourn.
Second?
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Do we have a clue on when our next meeting is going to be?
It will likely be our next regularly scheduled meeting.
Okay.
Which is August the 3rd. And so far, I believe they're all still going to remain on the Zoom platform.
Okay.
We'll have our newest appointee starting August 1. She'll be a member of the board, so her first meeting will be on August 3rd. Her name is Heather, I'm going to say it wrong, Cicerello.
and she will be our new newest board member.
Well, congratulations. We're looking forward to y'all being here on the block. Yep. Or X is on the block.
Yeah, you don't get to say that right now. You're in the nice cold place.
Right, right. Yeah.
Well, bring down a 60 degree night for us to share.
Please.
Yeah. Looking forward to opening the windows and have it be cool outside. Yes, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Y'all have a great rest of the day.
Yep. You too. Thanks y'all.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.